of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And also with you.
God invites us to come into his presence and worship him with humble and penitent hearts. Therefore, let us acknowledge our sinfulness and ask him to forgive us.
Holy and merciful Father, I confess that I am by nature sinful, and that I have
his servants and entrusted his property to them. One he gave 5 talents of money, to another 2 talents, and to another 1 talent, each according to his ability. Then he went on his journey. The man who had received the 5 talents went at once, put his money to work, gained 5 more. So also, the one with the 2 talents gained 2 more. But the man who had received the 1 talent went off, dug a hole in the ground, and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants returned and settled accounts with them. The man who had received the 5 talents brought the other 5. "Master," he said, "you entrusted me with 5 talents. See, I have gained 5 more. His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness." The man with the 2 talents also came. "Master," he said, "you entrusted me with 2 talents. See, I have gained 2 more. His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness." Then the man who had received the 1 talent came. "Master," he said, "I knew that you are a hard man, harvesting where you have not sown, gathering where you have not scattered seed. So I was afraid, went out, hid your talent in the ground. See, here is what belongs to you." His master replied, "Wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I have not sown, gather where I have not scattered seed. Well then, you should have put my money on deposit with the bankers, so that when I returned, I would have received it back with interest. Take the talent from him and give it to the one who has the 10 talents. For everyone who has will be given more, and he will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what he has will be taken from him. Throw that worthless servant outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." Son has served so perfectly and so well on our behalf, there is reconciliation between you and God. There is a peace that surpasses all understanding in your heart and in your mind. These things will guard and keep you steadfast in the faith until Jesus Christ returns to glory. That being true, please give your attention to the following select phrases from all of the scripture lessons. Everyone who was willing and whose heart moved him came. They brought it as an offering to the Lord. All the women who were willing and had the skill came. All the Israelites, men and women who were willing, brought to the Lord free will offerings for all the work the Lord commanded them to do. In view of God's mercy, offer yourselves as living sacrifices, each according to his ability. Well done, good and faithful servant. Let's bow our heads for prayer. O Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts now be acceptable in your sight. Are our strength. You are our Redeemer. Amen. Brothers and sisters, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, children, pay attention to me. Stop doing whatever you're doing. I'm going to need some help today. Right? Watching me? Thinking carefully? Okay? All right. Just the children. No one else. I need help today. I am going to try to move this altar from where it is to somewhere else. Let's just stay down on the floor. willing to pay movers to move the altar. Amen. Come on. Don't come up. Way up high. You're willing to pay to help professional movers move the altar. I know you would be willing to pay. You do not want your children to do it. No, you know what you're thinking? You know what you're thinking? You're thinking, he would never let the children do that all by himself. He'll do it. The pastor will move the altar. We're just going to go home and then we'll visit him in the hospital. So we have believers. Oh, let's ask the general. How many of any of you are willing to help move the altar? Raise your hand. Hi. Guys, some of you better. That's sometimes how it works in the church? Okay. That's sometimes how it works, you know? And who wants to help? And then as you raise your hand, you bend back so you can move. I'll tell you what you can do. Go back to your hand. I can use them now as examples. So, you know, that's the, when it comes to doing something for the church and you put out announcements or something, that's not just this church. There's a lot of churches. Are you willing to work for the Lord? Hallelujah, brother! I'm willing. Are you willing to do this particular task, Lord? I don't have the ability to do that. Will you pay to have someone else do it? Maybe. You know. And that's where part of the truth of what's promoted through all these texts comes out. The third sermon. I was afraid that my sacrifice would still result in your anger. So I decided not to sacrifice at all, not to invest at all, not to involve myself at all. I just buried whatever skills I have and just waited for you to come back and hoped that you would be happy with me being lazy. And the parable says that Christ would not be happy with that attitude at all. He's happy with willing. And then, sometimes able. But if not able, willing to. Well, let's ask that question. How many of you are willing to go to Brazil and be part of and start and live with a new mission station in that nation? Raise your hands right now. Willing to go. Boom. Okay. So, are you also now willing and able to sell everything you own and leave everything behind to do this? Raise your hand. Everything you own. Okay. Now, if they do this, selling their property immediately might result in sufficient funds to get them there and maybe sustain it for a year. How many of you are willing to pay to have John Schneider go to Brazil? Raise your hand! And even then we shrink back a little. It's the Lord's work, but we're still concerned that the investment on our part will either be insufficient or maybe we won't see enough product produced, enough souls won to carry the mission forward. So we hesitate because we're afraid. How will the money be spent? to say, well, I've served my time. I've served boards, commissions, committees, guilds, projects, on an endless list of all the things I have done. It's time for me to retire, just like we retire from our employment. Or we sometimes go, it's time for the younger people in this congregation to step up. And meanwhile, the younger people are going, I ain't got the time. I ain't got the interest. I don't really care because I've got my smartphone, I've got my game playing, I've got my whatever that is. See, I'm so old, I don't even know what you call them. And I'll be in my hands. I've got my internet, I've got my computer, I've got all those other things I want to do. And if I do something other than that, it reduces my personal time, my personal investment. It ain't over till it's over for all of us. Till you die, or until Jesus returns in glory, then it's over. But until then, your focus is supposed to be not on yourself, but on your Master, who has given me work. And you notice in that last text, each according to his ability. Each according to his ability. He didn't put any more strain on the third servant than he did on the first two. He knew them. He knew what they had done for him in the past. He knew what they were capable of doing for him in the present. And all they said was, do it. And all the other texts say is, do it for me. In view of God's what? Forget it already? View of God's mercy. So that it doesn't become about who you have to work with, or complain about who isn't doing as much as I'm doing. It always only becomes, as the first text said, for the Lord, to the Lord. It's an offering. It's an offering. I could do it by myself. I've done it many times. And I found smiles. But it still takes a lot of effort. We can move it a lot more efficiently and easier if we're all in one. Working together. In view of God's mercy. Not in view of getting praise from anybody else. Not in view of how others may view us as we're the faithful ones, but in view of only this, that Jesus took up the hardest task of all, took on our flesh and blood, took upon himself the punishment for our sins, lived such a perfect life as our God, and his Father said, I'm going to credit that perfection to each and every one of you. call on the name of the Lord shall likewise one day join him there, or see him coming in glory with all the angels and Jesus Christ himself. In the meantime, whatever vacuum they may feel in their lives at his loss, may they fill that vacuum with the good characters and sound virtues that he himself displayed, as an offering in memoriam to the Lord Jesus Christ for the good work he did throughout. We pray on behalf of our brother David Wolf. Father, you know better than we do the kind of employment he is seeking and the skill set that he may bring to gaining that employment and then performing that employment successfully. We pray that you would grant those who are taking up the interview process to see in him a valued member of this community and one who could be a valued member of their business, and move them to select David as their next employee at that position which he seeks. Now we ask this blessing because we know and love him as our brother, and we leave all things to your will. And we ask it in the name of Jesus Christ, who also taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Let's turn to page 35 of the hymnbook, the words of institution.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. and glorify you in the world, that the eyes which have seen the coming of your Son may long for his coming again, and that all who have received in his true body and blood the pledge of your forgiveness may be restored to live a new and holy life through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Yeah.
7 and about 7:45, and fellowship will follow after that. So please sign up on the sheet in the entry if you plan to attend. Have I missed anything? Would you like to know?